Join us, friends, July 30 and 31st for La Ho'ihoi Ea. This is where we celebrate Hawaii's Independence Day. We're going to have music, we're going to have mea'ai, we're going to have speakers like Ron Williams, Dr. Ron Williams. We're going to have Dr. Noi Noi Silva going to be talking about the Hui Aloha Aina Ku'e petitions, the history behind that, friends. It is good to know that there was a witness back in the day, and there is still a witness of today. Join us July 30, 31st. La hui hui ea. Aloha. Kau ko ohiri, o nauna I ka ihu, no hea I ka maka, liliko I ka ua, ki liruhune.
For government officials to join us up in Arizona come November 9th, where protocol with the Gila River people is going to take place. We're going to ask their forgiveness first and foremost for being in their house, eating from their icebox without an invitation. So we're going to make Pono Raheva first, and then we're going to ask them properly to come on their land and to come under the covering, because, you know, Kiakua, he gave them, that particular people, jurisdictional government over that airspace in spirit and in truth. That's how we can lock us rule. So I hope to garner some support from our government officials over here, or at least the U.S. government support, to come join, stand with us.
Just a closer walk with me. Precious Jesus is
my... We're about to enter into the governor of the state of Hawaii to hand deliver one of these fine invitations to join us in Arizona to protocol the Gila River.
Let it be, dear Lord, let it be.
Guys, mission accomplished. Let's go home.
Oh, aloha mai kako. Welcome to our broadcast, everybody. You know, we stay over here, Mauna Ala, where all the kupuna ivi stay. I stay standing on the bones of my ancestors. You know, the who's who, yeah? Give one story in a scripture that speaks about Israel was being invaded, and the Moabites was coming in, and cousin guys was trying to bury their dead. And when they were Makaspakta, Moabites coming, they just went grab the dead body, throw them inside the tomb, yeah, where Elisha was. And when their dead body went, touched the bones of the prophet, oh, that bugger went come back to life again. Friends, I've been touching some bones, man, and talk about coming back to life. You know, our Father indwells us, we indwell him, we draw nigh to him, he draw nigh to us. We got a word to deliver. Stay tuned. Aloha, friends, and welcome back to our broadcast. You know, the Lord says that hira way, hira truth, hira life. No man has access to the Father but by Christ Jesus. In other words, he made a statement. He says, hira door. You come any other way, you should be shot because you on thief and on robber. So notice how the Lord set that protocol. You know, I flashed on that topic about where the word tells us, except you bind the strong man of the house, you cannot go in and spoil his goods, take and utilize all his stuff. I thought about that flip end. There is a flip end to this. What would happen if you would ask the blessings of the owner of the house and he grants you permission to come in? When you come inside a house, he sets the precedence on how far you can go in accessing stuff that don't belong to you, belong to him. You know, here in the islands, we get one way on how we go empty house. That's a good example. We always come, if we like go empty house and we like go inside the house, we from the roadside, kaya, hey, empty! And if you saw empty through the window and she never respond to you, that means you keep walking because auntie might be up to some hanky-panky and it's not the time for bother her. However, if you in Kahea and she will respond, hui boy, ay, aloha, aloha, my, you walk up to the steps and that gives you the opportunity now to continue the conversation with auntie, perhaps state your case with her. And if she tell you, oh boy, my, come inside. Now you can go inside the house. Notice how, friends, the protocol of entering in with a blessing. In 2007, when the prisoners of Hawaii, our pa'ahau, they were in Kentucky, Mississippi, Oklahoma, and Arizona. They were scattered all across the face of the map. Prior to 2007, I would go visit every 3 months. I made a commitment to go and make sure that our brothers remain grounded, or if need be, throw them into the whirlwind and let God put them back together. I would make rounds to four states. But since the time has passed, all our pa'ahau, our ohana incarcerated overseas, is now centralized in one area in Arizona, in Eloy, Arizona, in the Saguaro CCA facility, privatized prisons. You know, I found out something that in this topic of protocol, you got to go to the peoples of the land because it's God the one set the boundaries for every people groups. And of course, it stems back to the time of Noah when the Wakawin land, God told him, guys, go forth, be fruitful, multiply, replenish the earth. Of course, took them 200 years, of course, to obey that call. During that span of time, they would build one tower. They would build one heiau on top to the elemental world, the spirit world. Instead of honoring the creator, God, they honored the creation that God put in place to hold his order. Colossians 1:16 says that he created things seen, unseen, whether it be thrones, dominions, principalities, powers. All things are created by him and for him, and by him they all hold together. So notice that he is the one created all of these elemental worlds to hold his order. Now go back to the Tower of Babel. Because the people refused to obey God, they built this tower, built on heiau on top to the elemental world. Now you know that when you get God all upset. So he came down and he says, wow, look at this unification. That's a wicked unification. Wow, there's nothing that they set their heart to do that they no can do. Come, we go down, we go change their language. So the Lord came down, changed all of their language, and now you know you're only gonna hang out with your homies, yeah? That, my friends, was God's mean of forcing a dispersion across the globe so that people can repopulate. Notice how the New Testament says that we come from one blood, and it's him, the Lord God, that created the boundaries of each people group. So go back to the topic of 2007. I have a friend, and he was an overseer chief of over Summer tribes in North and South Turtle Island. And I had asked him, I says, I want to go to Saguaro to go minister to our brothers, but I need to know who the stewards of the land. My friend directed me to the Yavapai Apache tribe. So in 2007, I flew up north. I went and protocoled the elders, the tribal council, and went with the shaman, who then took me to their holy place, which is a huge crater full with water. They did their ceremony. He gave me on walking stick and on eagle feather, and with their blessings, friends, I went in to do the ministry, the work of the kingdom in Saguaro facility. And back then it was Red Rock. Now that time when we went last short order, it was real short that term, and I wondered, gee, how come? What didn't happen? Something went wrong. Well, lo and behold, in the process of time, it was brought to my attention that the actual stewards of the land that the facility sits on belongs to the Gila River people. So when that was made known to me, a friend of mine, with the support of others, went before tribal council of the Gila River people to ask them if they would first forgive us for coming into their jurisdiction uninvited, that we, Kanaka Maoli, are a victim of circumstances. As you know, the United States of America have occupied our kingdom. There has never been a treaty of annexation whatsoever, which means we're not part of the United States. But that fictitious lie of incorporating a nation to make it the 50th state, you know, that's a long topic that we can cover and has been covered over 120 something years now. But my friends, my point being is this. The Gila River people, they were addressed. A handful of Kanaka Maoli went And they had asked the Gila River people to please forgive us for intruding into your land unintentionally, being victims of circumstances, for eating from your refrigerator without your knowledge. And when they caught wind of that, it took them by surprise, because there has never been any people groups that had ever come to tribal council of the Gila River people to ask such a thing. If any movement from Hawaii that would come to them, it would always be on a political plane. And you know, this topic has really nothing to do with politics, but yet the understanding of proper entryway with the blessings of the stewards of the land has all to do with it, because we're coming in, friends, into the covering of coverings, because the Creator is the ultimate covering in all of this stuff. So the letter that you saw me deliver at the beginning of this broadcast, we showed you footage where I'm walking through and going to the mayor, going to the governor, the mayor's office, the council members, to the Senate, right down to the Department of Public Safety, right down to the Office of Hawaiian Affairs, because, friends, we need someone from the state's end who are the responsible parties for breaching this protocol. And perhaps it was an oversight. You know, it's the benefit of the doubt action. But common people like myself understand the spiritual aspects to this and the important need for us to follow through with God's means of divine order. That's divine order action. That's where you and I, friends, can come under that covering of coverings, and we can have liberty because we got the blessings of the stewards of the house. And of course, they'll set the precedent on how far we can go with this. And you know what the beauty of this is? That it passed through twice through tribal council of the Gila River people. And they had passed it one phase to the next phase. And now, friends, as you can see on the screen, a letter was formed by the committee. It's the minutes approving the right for us to have the liberty within the Gila River community's jurisdiction, of which the facility sits on, that we have the right now to practice on their ancestral lands our cultural beliefs and spirituality. Now, that's a major impact right there. So come November 9th, friends, we're going to be going to the Gila River people in Arizona to officially do a protocol, although it was already done through passing through sessions of the Gila River Tribal Council. Now it's time for us to solidify this in person. And I just mahalo my brother, Kaleo Thompson, who has done most of the groundwork in holding the order until God could shift things around and allow stuff to happen the way it is transpiring here in the islands. There's a bunch of stuff happening. I mean, this is the hour of Huliau. Talk about the flipping, everything flipping over right now. All the things of the prophecies of the past concerning our nation, concerning our people, friends. This is the hour that prophecy is coming to pass. In previous broadcasts, I was sharing with you about a dream. Well, actually, it was a vision that the Lord allowed me to see live and in color. So I'm walking through this warehouse and blood all over the walls. There were beans all set up and had body parts all cut up inside. It was a morgue setting. I had a contingency of people. I don't know who they were. But as I was walking in, I realized that I, Kanale Kolearo, wasn't there to mourn the dead. But the Lord was showing me something, just like what he did to the prophet when he pulled him by the locks of the hair and put him inside a valley of dry bones and asked him the question, what do you think of this? What do you make of this? Kind of same thing is what the Lord did to me. He asked me, the Lord asked me the question, can the bones live? And I says to him, I said, I don't know, Lord, only you know. He says, open your mouth, prophesy. I opened my mouth, and as I spoke, I don't recall what I spoke, but whatever it was that came out of my mouth, I just saw the bones just jump out of the bins, came to the ground. Bugger was still prostrate and no had life breath. So again, the Lord asked me the question, can the bones live? And I said, I don't know, Lord, only you know. He says, look up. And I began to look up, and as if you could see winds that were divided. The Lord says, you see the winds? Gather the winds. Open your mouth. Prophesy. And as I opened my mouth to prophesy, and once again, I never knew what I said, but whatever it was that I said, I saw the winds come together, unify into one massive whirlwind over this prostrated, lifeless body. Then I saw that bug emerge, and when it merged, oh, the body that was on the ground stood up one army. Friends, in the developing of time, in the passings of time, the Lord has allowed me to see like a developing photo. You know, that kind of little chick, that thing come out and that thing develop, Polaroid photos, that kind. I have been allowed to see by the mighty hand of God, by revelation, the unfolding of this very vision that God has given me and has used me in an instrumental way, just like how he like used you, because we one body. No more plenty bodies here. Only get one head to a many-membered body of Christ. And the thing about this is that we're not total package. I'm not total package. I need you. You need me. And we got to honor and respect the Christ in each other, because he's coming forth through you and I, a many-membered body. This, friends, is that communion action. No wonder Allah says, eat me, drink me, become me to me. Because by doing so, we become him in the earth. We have already invited him to indwell and be enthroned in our hearts. And that's what makes him the king of all us kings. That's what makes him Lord of all us lords, is us relinquishing rights to rule on our terms. So you cannot just invite him in and he is enthroned in your heart and then you become his dictator. His kingdom no run like that. You and I, friends, relinquish rights to rule on our terms. We yield him right away. And it doesn't exclude you from the picture. It just excludes you having any say in the matter. He speaks and you, sons, hear his voice and you're moving in real time with him because you're at attention. Standing at full attention, paying attention. And as he speaks, you're moving with him. He go left, you go left. He go right, you go right. He jumps, you jump. You ask him, how high? You know, we follow him wherever soever he chooses to go, my friends. This is an exciting hour that we're in. We honor him in all of his magnificence, in all of his protocol, friends. The beauty of him being Lord of all, coming forth through a many-membered body. This is that stone cut out of the mountain without hands that will be cast at the foot of everything Satan has chosen to usurp over the ages. That Babylon system comes down and the glory of God, friends, fills the earth. You and I are part of that cloud mixed in with that great cloud of witness. Say no more. The glory of God is upon us, my friends. Till the next time, may the Lord bless you, keep you, make his face shine upon you, and you be blessed now. Aloha. Ahuiho e mala ma pono. All right.
sing a song of sovereignty wherever you may be. Throw your voice upon the wind and let it ring. Join the voices of the ages, an ancient melody. It's a song you should not be afraid to sing.
Dear Mr. President, I'm writing you today from the islands of Hawaii that seem so far away. I'm a native Hawaiian, as American as can be, and I wonder if you know of me in Washington, D.C., because somehow deep inside me, I still don't feel I'm free. You see, there was a time before 1893 when Hawaii was a kingdom with its own sovereignty. We lived a simple life, just taking what we need. But then there came this problem. I guess mostly it was greed. And the queen we loved so dearly seemed to have got in the way of some foreigner's desire to steal the land away. And when she tried to stand her ground, there was quite a scene, and she found herself at odds with the United States Marines. The rest is pretty much history. She lost her sovereign crown and ended up a prisoner within the palace grounds. So I guess I have to ask you, without sounding like a fool, what happened to the America I learned about in school? There's been some talk about Hawaiian nationhood. Mostly it's just talk, much of it misunderstood. And while it doesn't seem to me like such a bad idea, it sure got some people upset. I guess I don't understand what's wrong with wanting to be free.
Sibila aoke kanaka.
Join us, friends, July 30 and 31st for La Hoʻihoʻi Ea. This is where we celebrate Hawaii's Independence Day. We're going to have music, we're going to have mea'ai, we're going to have speakers like Ron Williams, Dr. Ron Williams. We're going to have Dr. Noi Noi Silva going to be talking about the Hui Aloha Aina Kuʻe petitions, the history behind that, friends. It is good to know that there was a witness back in the day, and there is still a witness of today. Join us July 30, 31st. La hui hui ea. Aloha.
No hea I ka maka, liliko I ka ua, ki lihune, ki lipohe I ke kaki.
Life's got you in a twirl, flipping out without a doubt. Tune in Sunday morning, 7:30 a.m., Monday mornings, 5:30 a.m. for a half hour of power right here on Lessee Broadcasting Network.